Let us continue the discussion. We were discussing two more examples of automatic control. The first one is the reeling of the paper sheets, okay, which is used in the paper industries and paper mills. Okay, now let me show you the block diagram. The main important part here is, here there are two drums and this is a roll where the your paper is being rolled. Okay, if you see the horizontal line, the paper is coming. It is passed in between these two drums. And you can see there are three pulleys, two, three, wherein these two are the idlers. They are called idlers. Their position is constant. Okay. However, this is third one is called the jockey pulley, whose position can be altered. Okay. This particular arrangement is used to maintain the constant tension. Okay. And after this, the paper is getting rolled here at the right end. The mechanism is very simple. However, the important thing is whatever the speed or the tension, the spreading of the paper, the tension with built in this paper and the tension at this the other side, these two has to be maintained. It should be constant. Done through this particular arrangement. Okay, it is passed through this particular arrangement. What happens if the tension increases or decreases? Suppose that this roll, initially it is not having any paper, so obviously it will it can move with a greater speed. However, the paper is coming with the and passing with a constant speed and the tension is maintained. So if this roll speed increases, what will happen? It will start rolling the paper at a faster rate. Ye zyada rahega, but however the tension is maintained on the other side same. Because of this, what will happen? There is a chance of tearing of the paper. Paper fatne ka chance rehta hai. But however, otherwise, on the other side, after some time, already the roll has got certain sufficient amount of paper. So because of that heaviness, it may happen that the speed of this roll, it may decrease. Because the speed is getting decreased, however, the speed with which the paper is coming, it is constant. So because of this, what will happen? There is a chance of losing paper ka roll, lose hone ka chance rehta hai. Properly roll nahi hoga paper. So these are the two chances. This can be eliminated. This particular thing, increase or decrease of the speed roll, it may cause either losing of the roll or tearing of the paper. This can be avoided by making use of this setup, that is jockey pulley. How it is done? Let's see. The jockey pulley, the jockey roll, it is constrained to a vertical motion. You can see this particular roll, it is connected to a spring like this, okay? And it is in turn connected to a motor. And this motor is driving this roll. So all are interconnected. The position of this jockey roll, that will either increase or decrease the DC, the supply is given to the DC motor, either it will increase or decrease depending upon that voltage. The speed of this roll, either it will increase or decrease. Now, suppose, let me show you. If there is a change in the tension, suppose there is a change in the tension of two sides, right, the same tension is not maintained, that time the jockey will be moved to the vertical position. Okay, this particular thing, because it is connected to a spring, it will be moved to a vertical position. Now, whether it will move upward or downward, it depends on the type of tension, whether it is increasing or decreasing. Suppose there is an increase in the tension. Increase in the tension means roll bahut fast ghoom raha hai. Okay, speed zyada hai. So, ye bahut yahan pe bahut tight ho jayega. Because of that, tension increases. If that tension is increased, this the spring, it will move upward. So, this roll, jockey roll, it will move to the upward position so that whatever, the voltage is given to the supply, this will be altered. Okay. as the speed is more, obviously the voltage, the pulley, the jockey roll, it is moved upward. So there is a decrease in the voltage. So the supply to this motor will decrease. Hence, the speed of the motor will decrease. Okay. On the other hand, the vice versa, what may happen is this roll may, because of the decrease in the tension, loose padne ka chance rehta hai, roll ka speed agar kam ho gaya, that time this jockey position, the jockey roll, the spring will expand, this position, it will be downward. So because of this, there is a voltage increase which is driving the motor, and obviously because of the high voltage, the speed of the roll, it will increase. So depending upon whether the tension is increased or decreased, jockey roll's position, either it will go upward or downward, readjusting the speed of the roll so that a constant tension is maintained in the system. Hope you understood the first example, reeling system. The second example, you can see a chemical batch process. You can think this in chemical industry, wherein you are putting some reactants into a vessel and you are mixing them with the proper proportions, and you are making some reaction to happen, and you are taking the byproducts. Okay, you can take any chemical industry as an example, making a dye or anything. For making any product, some raw materials are required. So what is the ideal process? The raw materials are put into this vessel and those are all mixed. And it is not like that, if you put all the reactants, all the raw materials together, and immediately, instantly, the reaction will take place and the final product will come out. It is not like that. You have to have certain conditions. Maybe a pressure should be this much, and the temperature should be maintained at this much, because the reactions to occur, it will take time, or even at some particular temperature, the reaction may occur. So those ideal conditions have to be maintained in the reactor vessel. After that, you can get the byproducts. Fine. So in this, what is that automated control? Let's see. This is the raw material we put inside. You can see there are many valves involved. Some 5 valves you can see. One is for the steam, the other one is for the cooling water. If there is a steam passing, so obviously after condensation, the steam, that it has to be eliminated. Similarly, if you are passing the cold water, and finally it has to be removed. Okay? For that, these 4 valves are there, and this is to put your raw materials, the reactants, and finally to get the byproducts out. So these many are the things, and this is an agitator. Agitator indicates it's a stir, to stir, mix karne ke liye, for mixing this particular part is there. So you can see, can anybody tell me what is a water jacket? Have you heard this? You might have observed, why I'm asking this is, if you you have a hot water, if you want to cool it immediately, within no time, what you do, you will put that vessel of hot water in the cold water, right? Because of that, the temperature of the hot water will decrease. Okay, temperature of the hot water will decrease. So this is the thing wherein the heat transfer is taking place. Yeah, that example. So why I'm asking about this is it's like a heat transfer, that the heat of one particular thing, it will get transferred to the other. So the same mechanism is being used here. Suppose that you are already this with the opening of this valve, you are putting all the reactants together and you are mixing them. And it may happen that after 100 degrees Celsius, your reaction is going to take place. So in order to maintain that 100 degrees Celsius, you have to check whether what is the temperature of that particular, the material inside the vessel. For that, this temperature sensing element is put. Say you have achieved 50 degrees Celsius now presently, but reaction is taking place at 100 degrees Celsius. So you have to increase the temperature. So in order to increase, what will happen? This steam is passed through this, okay, surrounding. So steam, its temperature will be more, right? Steam temperature will be more. So because of that, there is a heat exchange taking place. Heat transfer or heat exchange takes place. The heat of, the heat of steam, it gets transferred to the whatever the contents are inside the vessel. So with this, there is an increase in the temperature. So after that, after some time, again, this temperature sensing element, it will check whether the temperature has reached 100 degrees Celsius. Once it has reached 100 degrees Celsius, so this steam has to be removed. It has to be cooled down. Okay. Once it is cooled down, what will happen? The water droplet steam, after cooling, the droplet in the form of droplets, it will condense and that part will be taken out. And when the steam is getting passed and this process is taking place, increase of the temperature inside the vessel, all other valves are to be closed. Okay, their work is not yet started. So remaining three valves to be closed, only these two valves have to be opened. And once the temperature reaches 100 degrees Celsius, this element, sensing element, it will indicate the controller that, yes, the temperature has reached 100 degrees Celsius. Reaction is now taking place. So steam valve has to be closed. So after that, these two valves, this steam valve will get closed and the condensed part will be taken out and then this will be closed. Okay. So after 100 degrees Celsius, the reaction takes place. Once the reaction takes place, your product is ready. So after that, this valve has to be opened and the products are taken out. Okay. Before that, even your vessel is there, it has to be again cooled down, right? With the same temperature, you cannot take out. As an example, I'm giving you 100. It may not happen in the industries, really speaking. You may need a far more temperature, which is not possible to even touch, okay? For that, your complete vessel and the material has to be cooled down. So in order for the cooling of the system, this cold water is then passed. I have given an example of hot water. Aap garam pani ko agar aapko thanda karna hai toh, you will put that vessel of hot water in the cold water so that the heat exchange takes place and aapka pani thanda ho jayega. So you will pass. This is called water jacket. So this cooling water is passed surrounding this vessel so that heat exchange takes place. Jo bhi temperature hai andar, that high temperature, it will bring down. So after some time, when the temperature is down and sufficient enough, this cold water after passing will be taken out. When this operation is taking place, passing of this, obviously these two valves have to be closed. So obviously jab steam ka operation chal raha hai, cold water ke valves band hone chahiye and the vice versa. So all these valves opening, closing, everything is automated, automated, and obviously digitized computers are used to maintain and to observe for supervision purpose. These are used. So I hope you understood the second example of batch chemical process. Any doubts in these two examples? Let me just read it out. For a specific reaction, we need some optimum temperature. As I told you, when you put a raw material inside, you need to maintain certain temperature. After that, at that particular temperature, the reaction takes place. So because of that, so automatic temperature control has to be achieved. This we do it by making use of steam and the cooling water jacket. So what we do, steam we use for the heat exchange to increase the temperature. Okay, and the cooling water we use to decrease heat exchange will take place, and the temperature of the the vessel, it will decrease. During this heat exchange, whatever the controller we are using here, temperature controller, I told you, during the steam operation, increase of the temperature operation, this cooling water valves, all these have to be closed. That's what controller will close the water inlet valve, and it will open only the steam inlet valve, right? And once steam is passed, and after finally the condensed part will be taken out. So these two valves to be open during the increase of the temperature operation. But on the other side, the second time when we are cooling the system, what will happen in cooling part, only the cooling water valve has to be, those two valves have to be open. However, steam and condensation, those two valves to be closed. And all these, it is done automatically. Any doubts in the these two examples, please let me know. You can put it in the chat box. Any doubt? Okay, Sumaya is telling no doubts. Hope you have understood. Just by looking at the figure, you can, analyze what may happen, what is the mechanism. So what all examples we have considered now, this is for the automated control. This comes under the history and development part. Okay, the next parts in your textbook, it is given, it is the digital computer control, how that got invented, because see, everything is connected, interlinked. When we started in the history and development, we started with the speed control of steam engines. There we used a flywheel governor, and then with the inventions in the and advancements in the semiconductor technology and electronics, the integrated chips came into picture, and because of this, miniaturization happened. Then VLSI growth happened. The with the Moore's law, we are able to now put so many thousands of transistors and so many devices on a single IC. With this miniaturization, your device size is getting reduced. Because of these inventions, every other domain started developing. Because of this electronics part, your computers were developed very fast, at a faster rate. The memory got developed very the improvement, improvisation took place in that field. Because of that, antennas, whatever were used, their size got reduced. Because of that, the military applications got more. So everything is interlinked. So you have to see the importance of electronics here. In the upcoming another one or two lectures, we are going to look at I think these many examples are enough for you, I feel, for control system understanding. Further, now we have to check, we have to see the very broadly, we have seen the classification of control system as open loop and closed loop. Still, there are some more classifications. We have to look into those classifications still. And one more important thing, what is the effect of feedback on the systems. So jab hum closed loop le rahe hain, when we are using the feedback, what is the effect of these feedback system on some of the parameters of the control system? So these two important things still as a theoretical part we need to discuss. If we complete this, then we can move to the problematic part.